This is very exciting. If you're a female out there and wanting Charlie Kirk to tell you what to do with your life, you had a great opportunity this last weekend. Turning Point USA's Young Women's Leadership Summit was very exciting. And if we can pull up the first graphic, let me tell you about it. According to Madeline Peltz at Media Matters, Turning Point USA's Young Women's Leadership Summit targets college and high school age girls. Speaker after speaker emphasized the audience that they should become wives, mothers, and accessories to the astroturfed conservative movement rather than pursuing a demanding career. These themes were nearly identical to last year's YWLS or YWLS. Yet this conference exists because of the labor of women on the right who clearly value their careers. Speakers like TPUSA influencer Alex Clark, Fox host Laura Ingraham, The Daily Wire's Candace Owens, covertly and overtly discourage the audience of young women from pursuing high-powered careers, you know, like the ones they have. But it takes a lot of work to build an audience as a woman in right-wing media, of course. Behind the scenes, Turning Point USA's events and marketing leadership are also populated by women. Chief Marketing Officer Marina Minas' biography says nothing of her achievements in the domestic realm, strangely. The same goes for the Vice President of Events, Lauren Tonchich. But that wasn't the only contradiction this absurd event had on display. There was apparently also, brace yourself, a pride flag. No! The writer of this story shared, much to my surprise, the first thing I saw when I pulled up to the venue was a massive pride flag. In his opening speech, TPUSA founder Charlie Kirk described his unsuccessful efforts to have the flag taken down. Quote, I tried my best to take down the flag, everybody, he said. The crowd responded with cheers. I failed, okay, I'm sorry, I tried my best. I know you were all thinking it, right? What is that all about? By the way, this hotel better do something or we're gonna find another hotel. I'm not gonna come back, this is ridiculous. The ridiculousness is just a flag making the LGBTQ community feel welcomed in this world. It's ridiculous, according to Charlie Kirk. The conference featured an exhibition hall with booths selling dump your liberal boyfriend sweatshirts from a right-wing dating app founded by a former Trump White House staffer, I can only assume is single, career recruitment for Turning Point USA and Turning Point Faith, and bedazzled purses shaped like guns. Don't believe me, take a look at this here image. This is not at all insane, it's totally normal bunch of images, purses that can clearly hold almost nothing, shaped like guns. How exciting that is. Alex Clark, the host and face of this event, and host of TPUSA's Young Woman Focused podcasts, had a totally normal, not at all unhinged intro to this event as well. Look at this footage.
Oh my gosh. Young Women's Leadership Summit, are you ready to see this degenerate, rotten culture that we've been living in get a makeover? Well, you are in the right place.
Degenerate, rotten culture we're in, get a makeover, as they are in their 70s themed event, 70s attire. The makeover, yet again, these Republicans want is just to bring our country back in time. For the next 30 minutes, she launched into a winding pseudo-academic diatribe about the four lies of modern feminism, which according to Clark are birth control, abortion, fertility care, and daycare. She has staked her brand in part on spreading misinformation about birth control. It's a regular feature of her podcasts. Count me out on those. Then she finally spoke truth to power. She took on the great American horror of, wait for it, daycare. She described it as her spiciest take, saying that a lot of mothers in the 70s, the decade was the conference's theme, who desired freedom and flexibility or who didn't necessarily have a support system, were oblivious to the fact that the solutions presented to them as safe, liberating, or harmless were anything but. And one of those solutions was daycare. After an awkward pause, she added, it just got real uncomfy. Did you feel that shift? Yeah, cause you lost the room, girl. But like a real feminist, she persisted. Clark claimed the feminist movement is in large part to blame for the fracturing of the traditional home, where women were coerced outside of their natural roles as mothers into the workforce. She went on, the feminist movement gave way to the notion that a woman could have her cake and eat it too. You can have the career you want and you can raise your children in a positive educational environment, aka daycare. She described it as a lie to tell women we can have it all. But I'm sure everyone wasn't on the same page, right? There was probably someone reasonable in the bunch speaking to this group. Maybe fundamentalist podcaster Ali Stuckey? Fundamentalist podcaster Ali Beth Stuckey opened day two of the conference. She struck a notably more pointed Christian extremist tone than the other speakers, though religious rhetoric was ubiquitous throughout the conference. Quote, I can tell you what your highest calling is, she said. It's not to have a career. It's not even to be a wife and mom, as wonderful as those things are. Your highest calling is to glorify God. But nobody made the overarching theme of the conference more clear than the founder of TPUSA, the dolphin fetus himself, Charlie Kirk. Take a listen to these pearls of wisdom.
In my personal opinion, you should enter the serious dating pool earlier than not, right? I'm talking 22, 23, 24. This whole idea of putting your career first, I think, is a very, very dangerous proposition. It could work out for you, but I hear stories every day. Charlie, I decided to go become a partner at a law firm, and now I'm 32 years old, and I can't find anyone because all the good ones are gone. There is some truth to quote unquote the good ones being gone. The window does narrow, and so I think you should prioritize, what do I want most in my life? And if that thing is the best thing that I think a human being can do, which is to get married and have kids, then you should do that with clear intentionality. Thank you for the question. Appreciate it.
Anybody turning to Charlie Kirk to complain about the good ones being gone, hoping that that thumb face is going to have the solution for you, is just far gone. But Rayvana, I would love to hear your thoughts on this.
Yeah, I mean, as a woman who for too long has been trying to have it all, I think what I really need in my life is Charlie Kirk with his uppercase head and his lowercase face to get on a stage and lecture to me about my life. No, I mean, first of all, if someone is a partner at a law firm by 32, that's an amazing accomplishment. And I promise that woman is not complaining to Charlie Kirk about how she cannot be married. But you know what? Why shouldn't Charlie Kirk speak on women's issues? He's made a career of speaking on things he knows nothing about. I mean, for the love of God, Turning Points USA is an organization that was created to promote conservatism on college campuses. It was founded in the idea that conservative ideas are being suppressed on college campuses. And Charlie Kirk never went to college. So how would he know? How is he an expert at that? I also want to say that shout out to Candace Owens for going on stage at that conference and saying women are responsible for all the ills in society and that women need to stay at home and be mothers. And that if you're not a mother by 30, that then you've lost your edge, which she wasn't a mother by the age of 30. She didn't have her kids until she was in her mid 30s, which is fine. But apparently, it's fine for her, but not for any of the other women at the conferences. And of course, the irony of all those women standing up there and saying, don't have a career while they all have careers is utterly and completely ridiculous.
Sounds like some of these women are just wanting to reduce competition for themselves.
Right. Exactly.
I think the reason Charlie Kirk is up there saying, listen, ladies, if you don't find a good one by, 22, 23, they're all going to be gone. It's probably because his wife, I'm assuming, walks around the house all day muttering, all the good ones were gone. And just giving him the look like, you son of, but look, these people know nothing about anything. They go up on stage and they, I swear to God, have a job that I'm not going to lie, I'm totally envious of. Because you don't have to have actual research. You don't have to have facts. You go up on stage, you make up the most ridiculous sounding stuff people have ever heard in their lives, and you make millions of dollars. Like, that sounds like the best job on the planet, and they've got it. So I give them full credit for that. Nothing they say is true. They don't ever have to do research. We have stories and we have to pour through them and we have to go do extra research just to make sure. These guys, they just make it up. People eat it up. And I will say again, I get jealous of it sometimes because that seems like the most laid back, easy life on the planet. because you don't even have to worry about being right. You just say whatever crazy thought pops into your head and you get another $1 million off it. Sounds kind of sweet to me.
It does. And the people themselves who are sitting there in the audience, whose life experience does not match the advice they are being given, still cheer like complete blind sycophants at people who are telling them your existence is wrong. Give up the reason you're here. I have a strong feeling that a lot of women who are at a women's leadership conference aren't the same women who are trying to just stay home and take care of the household. They probs trying to get stuff done career-wise in their lives. The entire event is a complete conundrum and a hypocritical endeavor, which of course is what Talking Points USA was built to achieve. So another mission accomplished. Let's land on that hangar again and put the banner up saying human babies are the same as dolphin fetuses, Charlie. Well done, well done.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.